Hey everyone, I just wanted to do a video to show you how to create a monogrammed wreath. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to create a circle and I'm going to duplicate that circle. I'm going to change one of the circles to white so that you can see it. I'm going to resize this circle to be a little bit smaller than my other circle. And you could either move it around to where you like it or you could select all. And then you could align this so that it is in the center. Once I've done that, I'm gonna select all again. I'm gonna click slice. I'm gonna take out my yellow circle and then take out my gray circle, and I'm left with a ring. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna click on this ring, I'm gonna duplicate it, and then I'm gonna position it where I like it. Once I have it where I like it, I'm gonna select all. I'm going to click weld so that instead of it being two separate pieces, now it's one. I'm going to change this to black. Then I am going to upload a image that I found on Google that I liked. Resize it. And I'm going to resize my circles to the size that I want. Once I've done that, I am going to take my flowers, and I'm going to rotate them, make it so that it fits how I like it. Then I'm going to duplicate this and move these over to the side. I'm going to select all, and I'm going to slice this out. So I'm going to take all of the pieces that I don't need and delete them. And then I am going to take a circle and I am going to slice out the, I guess, imprint of the roses. I'm going to change this so that you can see it as well. Slice it to where it pretty much covers up the entire, like outline of the roses. I'm gonna unlock it so that I can make it more an oval, and then I'm go ahead and slice this once I have it where I like it. So I'm gonna select all, click slice again. I'm gonna delete everything that I don't need in the image, and I am left with my roses and wreath. I'm going to resize this to fit. And then once I have it to where I like it, I can select all and weld this. And now, instead of it being two separate pieces, it's now one. I'm going to take a square. I'm going to unlock it and I'm going to turn it into a rectangle. And I'm going to center this by selecting all, align, and center. Once I have it where I like it, I'm going to slice it. Take out all of the excess. And I'm left with two separate pieces that are still welded. So this is still technically one image. There's just a space in between where I sliced it. So if you were to cut this, it would cut in two separate pieces, but it would still be together as it is on the screen, if that makes sense. So then I'm going to go to shapes. I'm going to click on square again. I'm going to unlock this and I'm going to turn it into more of a long line. Once I have a shape that I like, I am going to click on it, click duplicate, and I'm going to make that same shape for the bottom. And I'm going to go ahead, and once I have it where I like it, I'm going to weld it all as one image. This over just a tad. I'm gonna select all, and I'm gonna click weld again. Once I've done this, I can go to my text. I can type in a name in there. So I'm gonna go ahead and type in Amber. Move it where I want it. I'm gonna resize it. And then I'm going to click on the letter spacing. Sorry, letter spacing, not line spacing, just to move the letters closer together. Once I have it where I like it, I'm going to weld it so that that is all one piece. And I can make it a little bit bigger. And then I can select all and weld this so that when I go to make it, it is all one image. Hopefully this helped you guys. And if you have any questions, leave them in the comments below and I will gladly answer. Have a great night.